You can install Home Assistant using several different methods. I tried them all for months, so you don't have to do the same. Finally, I decided to stay with Home Assistant Supervised method, as one of the easiest and probably the best one in my personal opinion. Let me show it to you. Hello, KPeyanski is here. In today's video, we will talk about some pros and cons of all of the available Home Assistant installation methods. After that, I will install Home Assistant Supervised on a Raspberry Pi 4 as an example. Home Assistant Supervised can be also run on Intel-NUC, Odroid and x86 PCs. Supervisor menu and add-ons are also working. So stay tuned for pros and cons of all of the official Home Assistant installations, or skip directly to Home Assistant Supervised. Let's go! At the moment, there are four official ways to install Home Assistant, and all of them have some pros and cons. The first one is called Home Assistant OS, which comes in a form of a ready-to-use image that could be used on a Raspberry Pi, Intel Nukes, Odroid and so on. Or you can use this image to create a virtual machine using VirtualBox or other similar software, exactly as I'm showing in this video. The pros here are a lot. You will get fully functional Home Assistant with Supervisor and add-ons. Everything is supported and regularly updated. But if you boot that Home Assistant image, let's say on a Raspberry Pi or Odroid, you cannot use this device for almost anything else. You get Home Assistant and that's it. Additionally, you can install only the available add-ons in the Supervisor store and nothing more. The second method to install Home Assistant is called Home Assistant Container. I have a video tutorial about it that you can check right here. This is really easy to install, everything is supported and regularly updated. The only requirement is to have up and running Docker client and internet connection for the initial part. But you won't get the Supervisor menu and add-ons when using the Home Assistant container installation. If you want to quickly spin a new Home Assistant instance and to remove it later without any complications, this is the best way. I'm constantly using this Home Assistant container method in my videos, where I usually test something and then wipe everything. Third method of the official Home Assistant installations is called Home Assistant Core, and it is somehow similar to Home Assistant Container. But this time Python virtual environment is used instead of Docker. Again, you will not have the Supervisor menu and add-ons, and few more steps are needed in comparison to the Home Assistant Container method. And the fourth and final method is called Home Assistant Supervised. We have the Supervisor menu and add-ons here. And we have the freedom to install Home Assistant Supervised on a lot of devices without the requirement to dedicate them to Home Assistant only. For example, you can have a Raspberry Pi with Raspberry Pi OS on which you can watch YouTube videos, and to have Home Assistant working in the background simultaneously. But let's see a real Home Assistant installation on a Raspberry Pi 4 right now. Connect to your device where Home Assistant Supervised will be installed over SSH, or open a terminal there. I'm using Raspberry Pi 4 with 4 gigs of RAM with Raspberry Pi OS running on a micro SD card. You can use the same setup or you can use SSD instead, exactly as described in this video. Of course, you can use totally different device like Odroid, Intel NUC or even desktop PC with Intel or AMD CPUs, as long as this device is having Debian or Debian-based Linux distribution installed. The device that you are connecting to should have Debian-based Linux distribution installed, that's Ubuntu, Linux Mint and so on. So these commands that you're going to see are exactly the same, and I will tell you if there are any differences later on. So first we have to update our Linux distribution with these commands: apt update and apt upgrade. I'll hit yes here.
after the update is complete, it's a good idea to reboot your system, and I'm going to do exactly that.
These are the dependencies needed for the official Home Assistant supervised installation. Let's install them!
After the reboot, I connected again, and these are the official dependencies that we have to meet in order Home Assistant supervised version to work. Docker Community Edition, Systemd, Network Manager, AppArmor, and Debian Linux 10, aka Buster. No derivates, but we are going to use a derivative of Debian Buster. Raspberry Pi OS is a derivative of Debian 10. As a result, we will see a not supported label in Home Assistant, but that's not an issue for me. This is an important note here. If you want to see that supported label inside your Home Assistant, you have to comply with this recommendation. You have to use Debian Linux exactly and nothing else. So let's try to install Network Manager and AppArmor using this command. Don't try to remember these commands, you can get them from the video description.
Docker is the next thing needed for Home Assistant supervised. I will show you how to install it on a Raspberry Pi. If you have different device, go to docker.com and check which is the best way to install it for your setup.
After the Network Manager and AppArmor installation is finished, it's a good idea to reboot and login again to your device. And the next thing that we have to install is Docker. We are going to use the official Docker installation script for Raspberry Pi. This command will download this script, getdocker.sh, and we just have to execute it using this command. So this script will download and install Docker for your system. After the official Docker installation script is finished, we just have to add our user in Docker group using this command. My user is Pi. If your is different, just change this to your username and hit enter. And we are ready with the Docker.
Time to install Home Assistant supervised. We will use the official installer script coming from the Home Assistant developers. That means the script will probably stay around for more than a minute. Now let's go!
Now we are going to download the official Home Assistant Supervisor installation script. Everything is official here, that means it will work for a long time. You can get this command again from the video description, and we just downloaded the installer.sh. Before we continue further, I just want to quickly show you something. This script installer.sh requires to add a machine type. These are the supported machine types. I'm using Raspberry Pi 4, so I'll use this one. If, for example, you're using Intel-NUC, you have to change Raspberry Pi with Intel-NUC. That's it, very simple. So I'll copy this command. Sudo paste Raspberry Pi 4. Again, if you have something different than Raspberry Pi, you just have to choose the right supported machine type. If you have AMD or Intel 64 bits, you have to use this one. I'll just hit enter now. Oh, we have a missing package here, JQ. We will quickly install it using this command, apt install JQ. Yes. Let's try again to start the official Home Assistant Supervisor installation script. I'll just hit enter. This time everything should be fine, but we have to wait for a long time here, depending on your device speed. Do you want to proceed with overwriting the network interfaces file? Click yes here. Install supervisor Docker container. Now is the time for waiting. When you see your prompt ready for more commands, you can try to open the device IP and the port 8123, which is the default one for the Home Assistant, in a new browser or tab. and you should see preparing Home Assistant screen. This can take up to 20 minutes. Be patient, this screen may be not visible in the first 1 to 5 to 10 minutes. So don't panic if you don't see such screen immediately. It needs some time, and if you see this screen, you just have to wait 20 minutes more. That's it, nothing more. We will continue the video after these 20 minutes.
While we are waiting for the Home Assistant Supervisor installation to finish, can you please tell me which is the best Home Assistant installation method for you and why in the comment section below. I promise to respond you back.
And finally, when everything is ready, you see that screen where you can create a user. You have to set a password and confirm it, and to create an account. You have to choose a location. I'll skip this. Home Assistant will try to find devices in your network that can be easily added, and it will show them to you here. But I'll skip this again, and this is it, the Home Assistant Lovelace. If you're wondering what next, you can check my Home Assistant playlist in your upper right corner, actually here probably, in your screen. I have a lot of videos, Home Assistant based videos. You can like something from there and implement it.
As every other method, Home Assistant Supervised is having some cons. If you want to see the supported label in Home Assistant, you have to use exactly Debian Linux and nothing else. Although I didn't find any differences running Home Assistant on Debian and Raspberry Pi OS, for example. As you have full control over your operating system, you could easily break your Home Assistant installation by installing or removing some software. So you have to be a little more careful with that. And pretty much that's it. I didn't find any major cons of Home Assistant Supervised till now. If you know about some, let me know in the comments. It will be very interesting to see them. By the way, if you are just entering the smart home world, you could check my digital product called Smart Home Getting Started Actionable Guide. It can literally save your money and time. Stay safe and don't forget, home smart but not hard. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.